Hello and welcome. This is Unit 1 of the Qt tutorial from tutorialcoding.com. In this unit I build an application that consists of a single widget. It's a label with the text Hello World. But what is a widget? A widget is a rectangular section on the screen. Widgets can be nested. A top-level widget is a window. Widgets are also buttons, labels, input boxes, and a number of other controls that I will introduce during the series. While in most units I will focus on explaining the source code, in this unit I also describe how to create a new project with the Qt Creator IDE. Furthermore, I explain what files a small application is made of. Let's get going. First, I open the new file or project wizard. The first page offers a set of choices of what to create. The left panel provides a selection of various project categories and fragments. The center panel narrows it down. I choose Qt Widgets application to create a new desktop application. The next page asks what the project should be named. I name this project Hello. The kit selection page offers different build configuration choices. These include the location of the compiler, the Qt libraries, and the debugger. The default kit is usually fine. The class information page follows. Here, the main application window can be customized. I set the class name to Hello World. Qt allows any class that inherits QWidget to be a window. Because I'm building a very simple application that consists of only one label, I want the main window to inherit the QLabel class. But it's not an option in the combo box. So I choose QWidget and replace it later in the source code. Qt Creator comes with a powerful user interface designer. The wizard offers to create a UI form file that is loaded on startup. This can be edited with the designer. I deselect this option. A good understanding of the structure and layout of the user interface is necessary to effectively use the designer. I will demonstrate these concepts by creating the user interfaces in the source code. The last wizard page shows a summary of the files it creates. It also offers the choice to select a revision control system. Leaving the wizard, I'm greeted with an editor window. It contains the main window source code file. On the left side, the Project Explorer displays the project files. The new project already has four files. The main function creates a Qt application instance which takes care of the program control flow. The function creates an application window instance and shows it. Finally, the application enters the main event processing loop. The header file declares a new class that serves as the application window. At the top of the declaration, this has a Qt object macro. This macro makes Qt object communication possible and should be present in any class that inherits the Qt object root class. The source file contains an empty constructor and destructor. The constructor is used to initialize the window. The project file contains the necessary information to build the application. First, it specifies the modules that are used. The executable name and build template follow. The rest of the project file lists the header and source locations. The wizard leaves us with a complete application that can be built and executed. It shows up as an empty window. Now I will start to edit the application. First, I cut away a few unnecessary things to better illustrate the essential parts. The core and GUI modules are included by default, making this part redundant. Widgets have been moved to a separate module since the major version 5 of Qt. The project file that the wizard has created is backwards compatible to old versions of the framework. Because of this, it has a version check before it includes the widgets module. I expect Qt 5 as a minimum version for a new project, so I drop this check. By default, Qt uses an older C++ dialect for backwards compatibility. In newer versions, it supports the 2011 revision of the standard. With an option in the project file, I enable the newer dialect. I use this in many units to keep the example applications concise. Application windows are widgets that have no parent. The class declaration that the wizard creates has an optional parent argument in the constructor that will never be used. I remove this for readability. Qt applications are very good at housekeeping. Qt objects have a parent-child relationship. When a parent or grandparent object is deleted, the child objects are deleted too. This results in destructors that in most cases have nothing to do. So I remove this too. I finished cleaning up the code. The application still does exactly the same as before. Now I start to change its behavior. The application window currently inherits QWidget, which is an empty container. But because this application will only consist of a single widget, I change this to QLabel so it can simply display a text. The purpose of the QLabel widget is to display a text or image. Currently, it has an empty string as text label. This is why the window is so tiny and empty. It shows text now. I could end the unit here, but the application window is still small and I will tweak it to make it look just a little bit better. I have told the window to resize on startup to a more respectable dimension. But now the label text is clinging to the left edge. I need to change the text alignment. There we go. Almost done now. To finish off, I set the window title. And the Hello World example is completed. Thanks for watching and goodbye.